ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time!
YouTube, salute. So I checked out the final press conference for Terrence Crawford versus Egas the Mean Machine, Kavaliauskas, and Richard Commey versus Teofimo Lopez. I can't wait to see the Commey versus Lopez fight. That's the co-main event. That's the most exciting fight I want to see on this card. I mean, I love Crawford. That's my boy and all, but I ain't really tripping too much. Just watching his performance. But Commey versus Lopez is going to be action-packed. It's going to be everything fans want to see. That fight is going to be epic. It's a 50-50 fight. So from the press conference, the final press conference, Commey was just calm, cool, collective. He was poised, and he's just saying, you know, I got everything on my back, representing Ghana. Lopez is just saying that he's trained real hard for this, and this is the moment he's been waiting for. His father and him are just excited just to show the world why they deserve a title shot, the first title shot. Kavaliauskas, you know, he's getting ready to have a baby. His wife is having a baby in February. So he said he was just excited, not just when she was pregnant, but when he was announced that he would be fighting Crawford, would be his mandatory. He's been training for 6 months, not 6 months of sparring, but more 6 months of preparation, doing all type of, you know, role work and calisthenics and things that prepare for a title fight, you know, cause you know, this is serious. Crawford was just being Bud. He was not saying too much, just saying he respects his opponent. He knows his opponent is going to bring it. He never takes, you know, no opponent lightly. He's not worried about Spence, Pacquiao, Porter. He's worried about the person that's in front of him, because if person in front of him wants to take his title. There wasn't too much trash talk between the fighters. Everybody was respectful, so you didn't see no disrespect. It would have been nice to see somebody said, I'm going to fuck you up. I'm going to beat your motherfucking ass. But I guess they're going to save that shit to the ring. The only thing you did see was Brian McIntyre, BoMac, Crawford's trainer, when Kavaliauskas was saying that everything he was going to do, BoMac was in the crowd and he said, you ain't going to do shit, motherfucker. You're going to get your motherfucking ass whooped. That shit was funny as fuck, though. I ain't going to lie. That was funny because BoMac, he's an instigator and he likes to, you know, hype the fighters up, and he wants to get under people's skin, so which is nothing wrong with that, but we need to see something going on. Show us something going on. Don't make it so boring and dull. I want to see something. So, like I said, Crawford versus Mean Machine, that's the main event. Lopez versus Commey, that's the co-main event. The Commey versus Lopez, that would be for the IBF lightweight title. Whoever wins that fight, if Commey retains his title, he's going to fight Lomachenko. If Lopez becomes the new champion, he's going to fight Lomachenko. Now, for Crawford, if he wins, he still, you know, becomes, you know, he still will be remain the WBO welterweight champion. What's next for him? Hard to say, because, you know, he wants to fight the PBC fighters, but they're not playing by game. People keep saying he needs to go to PBC. No, he fucking don't. Let him do what the fuck he want to do. If Crawford wants to stay on top rank and those fights don't get made, well, that's something that he has to live with. If Crawford does go to PBC and them fights doesn't get made, then what? Y'all motherfuckers looking stupid. Keep saying this shit. And everybody got to realize, shout out to my boy Goodfella Sports TV and shout out to Tom Business Sports Entertainment. Crawford cannot sign over to PBC, because that would be a monopoly. You can't have all the fighters on one promotion umbrella. That's a monopoly, y'all. So they wouldn't even allow that shit to happen. So we got to understand that somebody going to have to come and negotiate to make this fight happen. They made Deontay Wilder and Tyson Fury rematch top ranking PBC. Al Heyman and Bob Arum sat down to make that fight, so they can make this fight. So I don't want to hear that bullshit. That's all that PBC fanboys, Errol Spence, nut huggers always talking that bullshit, man. Why don't y'all sit y'all motherfucking ass down? Because y'all motherfuckers just learned boxing 2 years ago. Y'all don't know shit about the politics. Because trust me, if Crawford was some bitch-ass motherfucker that they can push over and they felt that they can whoop his ass, Danny Garcia would have got in the ring with him. And he was talking shit on Gilly the Kid's podcast, talking about, I can knock Crawford out. And look who he fighting. He ain't fighting nobody on January 25th. But I don't see y'all holding him accountable. So shut the fuck up. Post your comments below. Hulk smash Black Panther the like button. Subscribe to my channel. Click the bell icon to be notified when I upload new content and go live. If you'd like to support and donate to the channel, I have Venmo, Cash App, PayPal, Streamlabs. Everything's in the description. Until next time. Peace.